Hello my friends, this is for the Splish Splash Roger, and today we're taking a look into the free-to-play game Warzone in Modern Warfare, or actually the game mode called Plunder, which is a new thing. We haven't really seen this before when it comes to Call of Duty, and not in this big scale. So this game is about finding cash, protecting your cash, and getting the most cash. That makes sense, right? That's how you win the game, actually. And that takes place on this map, the same map as in, you know, the normal kind of battle royale game mode. So you start to launch in with your squad. You're only three players in the squad, by the way, which I will come back to. I think I'm wondering why and not four. But anywho, the plundering starts as soon as you get onto the ground. There's two different ways you might say when it comes to winning a game in plunder. And that is either to get a million in game cash, and that will end the match, or get the most cash in 30 minutes. As mentioned, you're three players, and you can earn these kind of money together by completing different contracts, of course looting, or picking up the cash that the enemy players will drop when they die, when you have defeated them. Then you might wonder, what's the difference between a normal battle royale game and plunder? Well, here you respawn after death. So you will lose some money when you die, so please think about that if you have some kind of money management going. So the only way to keep your cash safe is to deposit it by buying an expensive extraction balloon. You can place it wherever you want, and this is a great way to actually get it away fairly safe. Or you can also wait by helipad. When a helicopter arrives, which is a place where a lot of people will see you probably, and quite dangerous, you can send away your money right there as well. You'll have to remember that the money you do collect does not belong to your squad, at least not until you have deposited the money, as mentioned before. So you gotta hold on to the money individually until it's deposited. So we'll make the game shift a bit back and forth, meaning that one squad will probably have the lead and then maybe another one pick up the lead. And especially when you get in certain places on the map, which can be quite fun, you know, when you are having these gunfights over and over again with a squad, or maybe two, three squads, and then you get killed and then you spawn back. You go down with your parachute and you land almost on the head of the enemy and it starts all over again. It can be both fun and frustrating. If you have been playing the game mode so far, let me know what you think about this situation, and also of course the game mode as a whole. But of course these kind of variables also opens up for different kind of, you might say, strategies. I mean, we mentioned three players. Let's say you don't have any cash because you lost them and you're just spawning in. But your two teammates have a lot of money and you just want to, you know, deposit the money. I guess you can play a kind of decoy or be the one that takes the enemy heat, the enemy fire. That could be one way of doing it. Or you can pick up a vehicle, for example, a truck, and as I've seen some people do, yeah, get a helicopter and just fly around the map. I'm not sure if I like that kind of strategy. It's a bit boring in my opinion. I'd rather prefer the infantry gunfight going on the ground, but hey, we're all different, so again, if you win, you win, right? So I was mentioning contracts, which we'll find all over the map. These can include things like hunting down specific enemy players, which can be fun. Sometimes I mainly focus on that, actually, or capturing like certain objectives. So this will definitely also send you to a lot of different areas on the map, some areas that you might not have gone through if that wasn't the case. And therefore I think in this game mode you probably move around maybe even a bit more than a normal battle royale game. Maybe, I say maybe, depending on your playstyle and the objectives as well. On top of that, you also get the game marks that will show you the three squads within the game that has the most money at any given time. So that again will send you across the map and you will, you know, experience some different kind of situations and of course gunfights. For example, here I went on a place on the map. I had only one squad mate, so we were only two players, and there were people landing in here all the time, and I just locked down the area. I was lucky to do that, and I heard the footsteps coming and I just waited for the other player to come in, and then I killed him. And this was going on for quite a long time. It was kind of hilarious. I think they got pretty mad at some point. I didn't have the mic on, so I didn't really hear what they were saying, but nevertheless. But I think these kind of situations once again appear due to the high amount of players. If it's 100 players or a bit more, you will definitely run into a lot of dudes. And you have though to think if you're gonna actually engage in a gunfight, or if you have a lot of money and if you don't want to risk them, you should probably be better off, you know, trying to make a bit of a stealthy approach and get to that helipad and try to extract your money and all that stuff. But again, it gives a bit of a twist into this Battle Royale looking game mode, you might say. Taking place on the same map as the Battle Royale game mode. It also means that the game will end different again compared to a BR game where your squad gets eliminated or you die being the last man or two people in the circle. Here it can be that you reach the time again, 30 minutes, and the squad that has the most money wins. Or again, as said before, if you reach that million. I actually played with the squad where we reached a million within, I think, not more than like 8 minutes or something. It was a short game, but we won. If that's fun or not, that's up to you, but that's one way again of ending this game. The respawn thing in this game mode does put you in all these situations that I've tried to describe, becoming quite hectic sometimes, especially if you're hunting down a squad that has a lot of money. We were doing it here, and again, I'm playing with random players in most of these clips. But again, we were hunting down this squad, and of course another squad shows up later on where we killed almost the whole squad, and another third squad shows up, and yeah, I hope you're following me right now, because it became quite of a, you know, stressful environment, but also fun. If you like that, because I've seen a lot of people not really liking this game mode, and I would love to hear from you guys what you think about it, maybe just by watching and listening to what I've been saying, if it would be something of interest for you. Because remember, once again, Modern Warfare Warzone is free to download, so you can do that if you want to try it out yourself. But back to this, yeah, it becomes very hectic, and since you are able to spawn in, you will then parachute back into the action, and the kind of cycle starts over again. I don't mind this to a certain point, but it can become a bit messy, and that's the difference, I guess, from a normal BR mode, which is also the case in the Warzone game mode here, where you can play a bit more, I wouldn't say linear, but in a way it is. Here you have to be aware of like everything, like a new situation coming close to you at any point when the other enemy players are spawning back into the map again. So yeah, it is a huge difference from playing the normal BR game. Personally, I like to get into this game mode now and then, have fun playing. Yeah, there we go. Hiding in the truck, are we? also due to the fact that you can use your own custom loadouts. If you're not familiar with the Battle Royale game modes in general, you only spawn in with a pistol. Everyone has like the same weapons, and then you start by looting and finding better guns and moving on from there. But here you can try out your own like custom loadouts, and of course in the Battle Royale game mode here in Warzone, has to be mentioned though, you can, if you get enough money, you can go to buy station and get your own loadout into the game. But here you can use them all the time, and as I said, I think it's kind of fun and interesting to try out different loadouts in a game mode like this. So that's also a reason why I have been playing it quite some. And as mentioned, since I do respawn, it's kind of cool for a content creator, because I can just get into the gunfight pretty fast if I'm in for clips and stuff like that, and some sweet action or and funny moments going. So that's also a plus compared to the normal BR mode that takes a bit longer sometimes to get back into the action. But I'll probably talk about that in another video that will be dedicated to the normal kind of Warzone Battle Royale game mode. But here we are once again hitting the rooftops, and enemies are spawning in, and we're trying to get the money and also stay alive. You see, one of my squad mates are down, and I'm just trying to protect the other one. He's doing a good job though, so I don't have to bother. On the other hand, there's a guy landing above me again. I think that is like the third time or something, and here we go. By the way, you see a helicopter pad, and that was the objective, to try to clear the area so we could actually, you know, deposit our money. And yeah, that's how it goes. I think you get the picture now, and let me know what you think about it. I can say this again, I'm having fun when I'm doing this with a kind of loose attitude and not thinking too much. Sure, I like to win, I go for the win, but there are ways to win this game mode that doesn't implement so much gunfights, if necessarily. I say it will happen, but it can be another choice of yours, as described in this video. So for me, it's okay, but I can see all of the criticism regarding the game mode. There's, for example, a bonus round towards the end where an attack helicopter comes in. I haven't really still figured out why and why it's there and all that. Maybe you can help me out in this comment section of mine on this video and explain that a bit more for me. I also feel that the game becomes a bit long sometimes. As mentioned, you have to reach 1 million before you win, or after half an hour, the game ends and the player that has the most money, or the squad that has the most money, wins. personally, I wouldn't mind if the game ended at around 20 minutes. That would be perfect for me. And I also want to mention the three squad thingy. I don't understand why they don't have a four squad. Not sure if they're thinking about changing that or implementing that into the game. It's the same also in the normal BR mode, and I don't really understand why. This is a huge map, and I kind of like it. So far, it feels good. The different areas I have been visiting are cool and everything, and it feels good when you're fighting and all that stuff, which is, of course, of interest and very important. But I don't understand why we are three players and not four in the squad. Again, that might also be a question for you people out there if you're playing and what kind of thoughts you might have about it. But for me, I think this will be enough said for now, and I'm gonna stop talking, and you can check the video to the end. It's ending soon, but I have some more clips for you if you are interested, so check it out. So thanks for watching. If you're new to my channel, consider to subscribe and turn on the notification bell, and see you around. Game on. Bye-bye.